Hello and welcome back to the Proactive Investors New York studio. I'm Christine Corrado. With me on Skype today is Raj Ketkar from Arcadia Biosciences. Raj, great to see you today.
Hi, Christine. Good morning, and it's good to see you too.
Raj, earnings for the company were released yesterday, and we did see a bit of a loss in Q1 compared to the previous quarter of last year. Going forward, what will drive growth now for the company?
Yes, I think 2019 is really going to be a transformative year for us, Christine. There's three areas that I would really like to talk about today. One is commercialization of GoodWheat. We completed some production trials in our off-season production, and we're now getting ready to plant in the summer in the main production areas for wheat in the north and northwest of the United States. And that would provide us wheat grain for sales in the fourth quarter of 2019. So we're really looking forward to that. The second area is soybeans. Our joint venture with BioSeries in Argentina called Vertica completed now 3 years of breeding trials. And we've also done some seed production, getting ready to introduce it to our farmers in Argentina, again, by the end of 2019, when they will be planting there. Of course, that is pending approval from China for import grain from Argentina. And our third initiative is our hemp strategic business unit, Arcadia Specialty Genomics. We planted in Hawaii about 6 weeks ago, and that crop is flourishing very well in our test plot. We planted six strains of hemp, which are growing very well, and we are now getting ready to plant some more later this month. So we will start the breeding process there in Hawaii. We will also start the trait development work here in our labs in Davis, which we have started now, and we will be continuing through the year and hope that by the end of 2019, we make some good solid progress developing improved trait for hemp.
You mentioned you'll be planting your good wheat harvest. You'll be planting good wheat in the summer of this year. Are there any particular hurdles that you are facing to prevent you from commercialization at the end of the year?
No, not really. We are actually in discussions with several food companies. We have test material that we have provided to food companies. We're working with them on testing our product. So, what we would hope for is a good, successful harvest. The plantings this year are going to be a little bit late because, as you've seen, the Midwest is very wet right now and farmers are not able to get into the field and plant. So farmers will be able to plant our material by the end of May of this year and then be able to harvest in the September-October timeframe so that we can supply it to our customers in the fourth quarter.
You mentioned those three initiatives that are really driving growth for the company. What, in your opinion, do you see as the largest driver of growth?
I think for 2019, it's going to be good wheat because we're just further along in terms of development there. But we are certainly excited about our hemp business. I think by the end of the year, we will be further down the pipeline in terms of developing new and better varieties. And our research into developing new traits will have started as well. So that would be the other area. And of course, soybeans in Argentina through our joint venture Vertica should be able to launch. Of course, that depends on China approval on the regulatory authorities. And all indications we have so far are that we have a high likelihood that we could get approval by the end of the year.
Well, very good. Very glad to see the company is making great progress. Raj, thanks so much for your time today.
Yeah, thank you, Christine.